Hello there. In this video, I'm going to show you how to work with non-BX fonts in Embrilliance Essentials. Now, if you know anything about Embrilliance, you probably know and love the BX font format. But not every font that you find is going to have a BX format. Let's take a look at a free font that you can go and download. It's on 5 Stars Fonts Embroidery, and it's called the Freaky Embroidery font. Well, it turns out they do actually give you the BX format, but let's just pretend they didn't. Now, I'm gonna actually download the BX format and bring it into Embrilliance after I'm done with this demonstration, but let's just imagine we don't have access to it. So I downloaded the PES versions of the font, and it's sitting here in my downloads area, and there's a lot of stuff that I have in downloads. I got it as a zip file, I uncompressed it, and now I have a folder full of the font. So I'm gonna right click on it and say copy, and I'm just gonna put it in an easier place for me to find, which would be my desktop. Now, of course, if I were doing this for real, I would organize this and put it in a logical place. But I'm just gonna paste it here for now. And I want to build my name using this non-BX font. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say file, merge the stitch file, and then I will go to my desktop and I can easily find that folder right there. And then I will decide which size I wanna use. I'm just gonna say medium for now. And then I will get the letters that I want. So I'm gonna say J. And if I hold down my command key and click, now I'm on a Mac, that would be control click on a PC, then I can gather more than one. So this looks like the uppercase J, that looks like lowercase U, L, I, E. There's my name. I'm gonna import them, and now they're all on top of each other, which is kind of weird. But what I can do is I can take my J and let's take the E and move that over. Oh, that looks like a U. There's the E. All right, we got the U. And that looks, we just move our things around the way we need it. I could use my align tool and align them all at the same vertical point. So let's do that. We could select them all and I can say utility, align and distribute, and I can align the bottom of them if I wanted to, if I like that look. So once I have the letters all imported, all I would have to do is file, save stitch file as, and I can save it as a composite.pes file that I could stitch out on my embroidery machine. Now, once again, the only reason why you would want to merge in letters like this is if you didn't have that BX file format available. Like I said, this one, actually, I didn't realize it, but it does offer the BX file format. So I'm definitely gonna download that and import it so I can just type out my name and it would be much easier. But what I wanted to show you is that you can, in fact, work with non-BX fonts in Embrilliance. You just need to merge the letters in that you want to use.